Let's get into some baseball. The Yankees have found some trouble with a 6-2 loss yesterday, and it turns out it was a little more damaging than previously thought. The pitching wasn't great. The hitting has really struggled, and now Luke Voit and Corey Kluber, after last night's game, will both be headed to the IL. Voit, an oblique strain. Corey Kluber out 8 weeks with a subscapular strain in his right shoulder. So two key pieces for the Yankees missing some time, and particularly disappointing for Corey Kluber, because this is a guy coming off a no-hitter, somebody who had pitched so well for the Yankees in the last couple of weeks. You feel like they have finally figured out that number two behind Gerrit Cole, and with the way that their rotation had been humming through the last turn through, you felt like the Yankees' offense was going to get things going, and maybe the pitching wasn't going to sustain this level of success, but they were winning games in a way that would bode well come postseason time. And now the shoulder coming back to bite Corey Kluber again, and a team that behind him might be searching for some answers with how to fill out the rest of that rotation.
Yeah, that Kluber injury, it really just kind of blindsided the team. And I think it's going to be a tough blow. I mean, I usually am one to say that the Yankees can bounce back from injuries well, but Corey Kluber was so important to that rotation. And, you know, having the really good number two behind Cole was so important. And now they're losing that. And the concerning thing is that, you know, he only pitched one inning in the shortened 2020 season. And it was the same shoulder that he injured last year that he's dealing with now. So I really don't know what's going to happen going forward, but the best case scenario is a return by late July, which doesn't look great. And again, that's the best case scenario. So with most of the Yankees' injury history and given their luck, you can kind of assume that it's going to be further back from that. So I think it's concerning. Now, Davey Garcia is going to rejoin the rotation. You know, he had a start this year that was okay. And, you know, he showed some promise last year. So if he can step up, that would be huge for the Yankees. But I don't know if they can replicate what Corey Kluber's given them throughout the first 2 months of the season.
No, it'll certainly be tough. And I think it's incredibly disappointing just with how well Corey Kluber was able to pitch. And I think that you brought up a really good point in that he only pitched the one inning for Texas in 2020. And of course, it's concerning that it's the same shoulder. But even further than that, this is a guy that's going to need a few starts to shake the rust off. He just hasn't pitched a lot in the last couple of years. And now he's going to be out for 8 weeks, probably longer. That's the best case scenario, as you mentioned, which probably won't happen for a guy with this type of injury history. So now you're talking about when is he able to come back and what is the buildup going to look like for him to be ready for the postseason, if that's where the Yankees are headed. It seems like they are playing better of late, but it's just incredibly disappointing for a guy who just threw a no-hitter and did all that he did to get back, and then to do it in the place where he blew out his arm a year ago, and now to be headed right to the IL with that injury is so disappointing. And the Yankees are going to have to figure it out. This is a team that is not like what we've seen for them in the last couple of years in depth. They had a ton of injuries in 2019 when it was next man up mentality, and they were able to cover things pretty well and find a way to progress through some of the things that really were a struggle for them because of the injuries. And now it seems as though that depth is not there in the same way. Of course, there are still more injuries, but a guy like Mike Ford, who came up in 2019 and was really good, he has been brutal for them in their lineup when he has played. Cameron Maben was a guy who stepped up. Mike Tauchman was a guy who stepped up. Clint Frazier is doing a better job right now in his last couple of games getting things going with the bat. Brett Gardner was seeing more time and is seeing more time this season, and he's batting below 200. Gary Sanchez, Kyle Higashioka, guys who have not been able to get things going for them offensively. And then the rotation, while it has been very good, the longer you look down the depth chart, the less encouraging that it is. And you're hoping that Davey Garcia can come in and fill the void. But after that, there's not a lot. And now you're holding out hope that maybe Luis Severino can come back and save your bacon at the end of July. But that's a lot of ifs and a lot of question marks for a team and a general manager in Brian Cashman that usually has their boxes checked. This time it hasn't been the case here in 2021 so far.
I mean, with all the injuries that have piled up, you know, Hicks is looking like he's done for the year. He's getting surgery on his left wrist. You know, they brought in Ryan Lamar to be a, you know, bench player who can play center field when he can. And now he's hurt. He's on the IL. And, you know, when you see all these pile up, I mean, how does that Mike Talkman trade look that you made in April? I mean, Mike, the Yankees could really use a player of his.
I guess Talkman hasn't played well either.
That's true. But I mean, really, Clint Frazier has not been getting it done, although he has been better as of late, but he really hasn't been getting the job done. I don't really know how well a 37-year-old Brett Gardner playing center field every single day is gonna turn out, because I don't know who their center fielder could be outside of him. I mean,
Esteban Florio.
That's true. They could bring him up.
That's the problem. They don't want to bring him up because exactly. He can't hit.
I don't really get it, but I mean, and now the Voit injury. I mean, that's killer. So your infield is gonna be LeMahieu is gonna play first, and then you're gonna have Odor, who's a likable player, but he's had his own issues with the bat and he's struggled offensively. And, you know, the Yankees just have a lot of guys who are below the Mendoza line. And, you know, you're going to hope that the pitching rotation can stay afloat, but the injuries, they have to be concerning. And really with the lack of depth, you got to wonder the direction of this team going forward.
And that's not to call into question the pitching rotation that had been absolutely outstanding this last turn through. They threw 36 straight scoreless innings. So this has been not a good rotation, but a great rotation. I mean, they have been outstanding. But the problem is that's not sustainable. This is not a team that is going to pitch that well for an extended period of time. So then you look into, how does this team manufacture wins? And the offense needs to improve. They just haven't been able to score runs the way we're accustomed to seeing the Yankees score runs. And that's just been the puzzling part of it, because yes, they have dealt with the injuries, and we can go up and down the list with Voit missing the time to begin the season, and now he's out again, and Hicks and Stanton and the injuries that they've dealt with. But Aaron Judge is still playing every day, and Clint Frazier is still playing every day, and Urshela and Torres has gotten it going, and LeMahieu is another guy who has been questionably suspect throughout the beginning of this season. But it's just amazing to see how they have really struggled to get things going offensively, because if you had told me going into this season that the Yankees were going to pitch the way they pitched, I would tell you that they were running away with the division in the early going, just because you operate under the assumption that they're always going to hit. They're the Yankees. It's what they do. And yet that hasn't been the case, which has been just really an interesting development, and not in a positive way for the Yankees and the front office and the fans and everybody who's there. But it's just unfortunate, because now when you don't score runs, it puts so much pressure on every other aspect of the team. And that is the starting rotation, and that is the bullpen, and the reserves who are coming in when you have injuries. And now Davey Garcia can come in, and as a guy who was a borderline fourth, fifth starter, much in the same way that you would consider him maybe a Jordan Montgomery type of pitcher, where it's going to be some good and some bad for him as he makes his starts throughout the regular season. If Davey Garcia, under normal circumstances, or at least what you thought you were going to get, pitches to a 4 ERA, you're good. You're going to win three quarters of his starts, because that's what the Yankees do. They score runs. And yet, if he pitches to a 4 ERA with the way this offense is going right now, it's going to be a struggle for them, because they're just not scoring. And I think that is the most concerning part of the Kluber injury. Not that the rotation is necessarily in a bad spot. They have pitched incredibly well, but because of the shortcomings of the offense, this is going to be a challenge for them because they just haven't found ways to score. So there are two ways to fix it. You keep pitching the way you keep pitching. I don't know if you put all your eggs in that basket because it's really difficult. They got to find a way to get things going with the bats.
Yeah, it's been really confusing. And, you know, you like to use the, oh, it's early argument, you know, throughout the first couple of months, but we're at the end of May. We're about to enter June. The it's early argument for like Higashioka and Gary Sanchez and Clint Frazier, that's about to go out the window. I mean, you're getting to a point where they're going to get in a really tough hole to dig out of. And I just don't get it how the bottom 6, 7, 8, 9 in their lineup, it all has hitters under 200. And it does put a lot of pressure on the rotation. And you got to hope going forward that Herman is able to keep going on the role that he's going on. He's pitched tremendously. And, you know, maybe they're now in the market to get someone at the trade deadline. You know, do they go after another pitcher with the Kluber injury, or do they try to fix some of their depth? You know, there have been rumors about Joey Gallo, but then again, what does that do? I mean, you have a bunch of hitters with who can't really put the ball in play, and Joey Gallo is the epitome of that. I mean, he's close to 200 and he leads the league in strikeouts. So I don't know what that would do. It's just a puzzling time, and you need to hope that, you know, based off of reputation, Clint Frazier can get it going and hopefully all of it will work out. But as of right now, offensively, I don't know where the Yankees are getting production from their bottom guys in the order.
This is a team that's going to make a move at the trade deadline. Last couple of years, it's been quiet. And last year, there was some questionable looks from fans and people who follow the Yankees saying, wow, we thought they were going to do something at the trading deadline. We didn't like it. Was the starting rotation that was the main question. And I don't believe that they didn't make a move. That was the mantra from the people who were paying attention. That won't be the case this year. The Yankees are going to make a move, and they're going to add something to at least the depth of this organization, because it has been tested, and quite frankly, it has failed over the last couple of weeks. And they've remained afloat because of how well they've pitched in the starting rotation. But as we've said, it's not sustainable. So we'll see how they will adjust. And there are a number of rumors. Talked about Chris Bryant on Bleacher Report. I saw an article. Could the Yankees try and make a play for him? Would the Yankees kick the tires on Trey Mancini? Of course, Baltimore seems to be pretty well willing to unload absolutely anybody worth anything of value with the way they stand in their organization right about now. But it's just this will be a year where you're going to see a move at the trading deadline, because this Yankees team in the lineup in particular is not one that can stand pat with even the depth that they have. So I would certainly expect a move, and a corner outfield spot might be a good place to start. Maybe someone who can play some center field, somebody who can help them generate some offense.
Absolutely. I mean, you really have to make a move at this point. I mean, the Yankees are, you know, they're average in, they're pretty much middle of the pack in runs scored, which is not what you expect from this team. And, you know, it's puzzling, really. I mean, DJ LeMahieu has not been the 340 hitter that you expect him to be. Although out of all the guys who are struggling, I do think he's the most likely to be all right in the end. But, you know, I saw something that Delino DeShields, who's kind of been an off and on major league player, he's a possibility. And, you know, usually when they bring in those types of guys, it usually worked out well for them. But I mean, you have a player like Florial in the minor leagues. I mean, I don't see what's holding them back from bringing him up, especially now with this Voit injury. But I mean, the Yankees, their hitters, I mean, they have talented guys in their lineup, but this year they're not getting the job done. And I just don't see how the Yankees could really, you know, step up and compete in this division if these guys don't get going. If Clint Frazier is hitting 180 the whole season, you know, I don't see how they can step up. But I'll think optimistically, and I'll still say that the Yankees can win this division. You know, the hitters, for the most part, you can say are too talented to be this bad for this long, but the time for Wayne to get going, it's almost up. You know, the Yankees need to start hitting, or else they're going to have a tough time catching the red hot Tampa Bay Rays and even the Boston Red Sox.
Yeah, it's a very good division, and it's certainly something the Yankees are going to have to try their best to iron out. We'll see if some of these guys can get back to the mean positively, because you feel like the roster is better on offense than it is playing right now, but it's why you play the games and your stat line is who you are, at least in 2021. So the Yankees hoping to get a little bit more from guys like Clint Frazier or Mike Ford or really DJ LeMahieu, Gary Sanchez, Kyle Higashioka. The list goes on and on, unfortunately, for them to keep pace with a Red Sox and Rays teams and the Blue Jays, who have come into town. And I know they had lost six straight and the pitching doesn't look great, but that's a team that can swing it and can score. So there's a pretty darn good division. I hate to exclude the Baltimore Orioles from that, but we know where they fall in this whole conversation.